Assalamu alaikum class 5, it's our 9th lecture of English. So today we are going to study New Oxford Modern English book 5. First of all, open page number 28, mention the date at the top of the page, unit 3, Robinson Crusoe. So Robinson is the main character of the story. In this, he had told us about how he had overcome his dangers, what's to know, ammunition, bullets, shells, missiles and other things used as weapons, course, route, way, gigantic, huge, very large or tall, hurricane, a severe tropical storm, mast, a vertical pole that supports the sails on a ship, overboard, over the side of a ship and into the water, resolve, set on a particular course of action, decided, stockade, a tall fence or enclosure made of wooden posts to keep out enemies, tornado, a destructive funnel shaped rotating column of air, a windstorm, vessel, a ship, violent, using physical force to cause hurt or damage, voyage, a journey by sea or air, especially one to a distant place. So, the first paragraph is introduction. Robinson Crusoe is the name of a book by Daniel Defoe. Daniel Defoe was born in 1660. His father was a butcher and Daniel Defoe worked at a number of trades before he started to write at the age of 40. So, Robinson Crusoe is the name of a book written by Daniel Defoe. He was born in 1660. His father was a butcher. He worked at a number of trades. Trades mean tijarat, butcher mean kasai. He started to write at the age of 40. He wrote poems and occasionally wrote criticism of the government. Sometime he was sent to prison when he was nearly 60. So he had written poems and occasionally written a criticism on government and he was sent to prison when he was nearly 60. He wrote the story of Robinson Crusoe. It was a great success and has been popular with children ever since. So it was a great success. It is the first great English novel. In this short piece of the book, Robinson Crusoe tells us how he became shipwrecked. So this novel is about how he became shipwrecked. Jahaz ki tabai. Shipwreck means jahaz ki tabai. We started, so now we will begin with the story. We started off on our voyage in good weather, although it was very hot. After about 12 days, however, a violent tornado came from the north. So they started their journey with a good weather, and it was very hot, and the weather was hot. About 12 days of their journey, a violent tornado came from the north. So a tornado means andhi tufan. So tornado came from the north side. The wave rose high, the skies were black and the wind howled through the sails. So the waves were high, the skies were black and the wind howled through the sails. So the wind was too fast. Two members of the crew were washed overboard. And after a day or two, the ship began to leak. So after 1 or 2 days of journey, the ship began to leak. We changed our course and sailed off the Hurricane. So they changed their way and sailed off the Hurricane. course mean rasta, Yurisen mean tufani andi. But the next day a second terrible storm attacked us. So the second terrible storm attacked them again on the next day. We could see, terrible mean hofnak, we could see the shore of some unknown land, but the sea was very rough. So they are able to see the shore of some land, but the sea was very rough. The rain dashed down. Dashed means tezi se dorna, and we were afraid to approach close to the land, and they were afraid to reach to the land. Our only hope was to clamber into a small boat and try to row to the shore. Clamber mean mushkil chadai, so their only hope was to sail in a small boat and reach to the shore. Four of us managed to get the boat into the sea and we jumped into it. We rowed with all our might, but the waves were like mountains. So they managed to get the boat into the sea and they jumped into it. But the waves were like mountains. We struggled on, but at last a gigantic wave greater than all the others hurled our little boat into the air and it sank beneath us. So a gigantic wave came over them and their boat sank into the water. Gigantic mean bahut bada. Struggle mean कोशिश, hurl mean जोर से फेंकना, beneath mean नीचे. I am a good swimmer and for an hour and a half I battled in that stormy sea. So he was a good swimmer and he battled for 1.5 hours in the stormy sea. Battle mean जद्दोजहद करना, stormy mean तूफानी. As I caught sight of the coast, a huge wave would lift me up and carry me out to the sea again. So again a huge wave lift him up. I tried to reach the shore again and again, and I was thrown away by the raging seas again and again. So he tried to reach the shore again and again, but the waves were too high. At last I was hurled towards the shore and fell down exhausted on the sand. So at last with hard struggle he reached to the shore and exhausted on the sand. Exhausted mean thakan se. The night was dark without a star in the sky, and I knew that lying on the sand would be dangerous. So the night was dark and there was no stars in the sky, and he knew that it is very dangerous for him to lying on sand. I crawled away from the sea as fast as I could and come to some bushes and trees. Crawl mean ringna, so he crawled from that area and reached to the some bushes and trees. I did not know what wild animals there would be in the forest, so he is unaware of the wild animals in the forest. So I climbed up one of the trees and made myself comfortable to great branches. There I slept the night as well I could. So he left himself to the great branches and he slept there. In the morning I looked out across the sea and there was our ship. A quarter of a mile away from the shore I came down the tree and found a stream where I drank some of the cool fresh water. So next morning he could see his ship. And a quarter mile away from shore, he found a drinking water. I lay down and slept again. He lay down and slept again. The sun was high in the sky when I woke up. I resolved to go out to the ship and try to bring by bring back some things which would be useful to me on the island. So resolve mean faisla karna. So he decided to go to his ship and get some useful things from them which will be useful for him on the island. Island mean jazira. Assalamu alaikum class 5, it's our lecture 9 part 2. I plunged into the sea and made for the ship. At last, after a hard swim, I managed to reach it and discovered a rope hanging over the side. So he dived into the sea and made for the ship. At last, with hard swim, he's managed to reach it and he discovered a rope hanging over the side. With great difficulty, I pulled myself the rope and reached the deck. So with great difficulty, he reached the rope and the storm had damaged everything. There were broken masts and torn sails and pieces of rope all over the ship. So the storm had damaged everything. I went down into the cabins and found an axe. So he went down to the cabins and found an axe. One on deck again, I cut the mast and ropes and went into the cabins and myself a small raft. I managed to get this raft into the sea and tie it to the vessel with a rope. I found some of the seamen's boxes on board and filled them with stores. So he found some seamen's boxes on board and he filled them with stores, bread, rice and cheese. All these I piled on to the raft. Piled me there and having found a broken oar, I cast off from the vessel and started for the shore. So, cast off mean nijat palena, vessel mean jahaz. So he went off from that and start his journey to the shore. When I reached the sand, I carried the things up on the dry land. The next morning I walked along the shore and up a little hill. From there I could see that I was on an island. I was a prisoner without a friend in the world. There was no one living on the island but wild beasts. So the next morning he was able to walk along the shore. He was a prisoner on that island because there was no one living in that island except beast mean vahshi janwar. The next day I went back across the sea and brought more stores from the ship. Every day I toiled. I brought tools, wood, ropes, nails, sails and clothes, guns and ammunition and sugar and flour and bread. In one of the wooden boxes I found gold and silver coins. The sunshine made them sparkle. So the next day, he went back across the sea and brought some more things from the ship that were tools, wood, rope, nails, sails, clothes, guns, ammunition, sugar, flour, bread, wooden boxes, and some gold and silver coins. Sparkle means chamakna, ammunition means samane jang, toil means mehnat karna. What are you to me, sir? I ask. Everyone in the world desires you but me. What use are you to me? So he asked the things. What use are you to me? Everyone in the world desires you but me. When I got back to my island, I noticed that the sky was black. Great clouds rolled up from the west. So when he reached to the island, he found that the sky is black and great clouds covered the sky from the west. The rain poured down. I saw the ship out at sea rise and then sink beneath a huge wave. And he saw that a ship again sink beneath the huge wave. During the next few months, I busied myself in making a house with a strong stockade around it. Lakdiyon ki baar. Stockade mean lakdiyon ki baar. I used one of the sails from the ship for the roof. I cut down tree trunks and carried them to the house. So he cut down the tree trunks and carried them to the house and slowly built a strong stockade to keep out wild animals. So he was building a house for himself. The months passed in hard work and one day I set out to explore the whole island. Explore means darya. The journey took me 3 days and when I got to the other side of the island, I found a delightful valley. So the journey took him 3 days to complete. So when on the other side of island, he found a delightful valley. Valley mean wadi, island mean jazira. There were wild grapes and limes and I collect a quantity of these and took them back to my house. There were grapes and limes, so he collected a quantity of this and took them to his house. One day in the forest, not far from my house, I found some wild goats. I was just about to shoot one when I saw at my feet a baby goat. I picked it up and carried it home with me. Few days of his journey, he found wild goats. He was about to shoot, but when he saw it feed a baby goat, he picked it up and carried it to home. In a few days, it became quite tame, and after that, it never left my sight. So, the baby goat never left him. After a year or two on the island, I decided to make a small boat. I chose the wood carefully and cut and worked the timber for many months. So after 1-2 years on island, he decided to make a small boat for himself and carefully cut and worked the timber for many months. Timber mean lakdi. I made a sail from some of the canvas I had brought on shore from the ship, and with a good wind the boat sailed well. I taught myself how to make boats out of mud and how to make them hard and durable by burning them. So he taught that how to make pots out of mud and how to make them hard and durable by burning them. I grew some corn and rice and also some wheat. So he planted some corn and rice and some wheat. I taught myself to make bread. So he taught himself to make bread. My life on island was a happy one. So I had a good house, plenty to eat and plenty of work to do. Plenty mean kaafi. So his life was good on island. He had a good house, plenty of food, plenty of work. One day I was walking along the seashore thinking about my home across the seas when I suddenly looked down. So one day he was walking on the shore thinking about his house. When I suddenly looked down, there on the sand in front of me was a clear footprint. It was not mine, but the footprint of another man. So there was a hop of prey. He found it. There was a footprint of someone. It was not his. So this is the end of chapter. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.